Pro Football Focus has ranked the quarterbacks. They've got Mahomes 1, Brady 2, Aaron Rodgers 3, Russell Wilson 4. Not that big of a surprise. Then you got Watson, Josh Allen, Dak Prescott, Lamar Jackson, Matt Ryan 9, and Baker Mayfield 10. Baker at that spot doesn't surprise me necessarily. Behind Matt Ryan, not so sure I'd rather have Matt Ryan at this point in his career, but what do you make of Baker Mayfield as, you know, quote-unquote a top 10 quarterback?
I think it's really interesting to see him ranked that highly. And I think there's a lot of flexibility there in those rankings. I've never been the biggest Matt Ryan fan to begin with. So, you know, I wouldn't argue if you put Baker Mayfield in front of him. But, you know, really with a lot of those guys, it's just more of, you know, Lamar Jackson has won an MVP. Josh Allen really took huge steps forward last year and led his team to the AFC Championship game. And that's just sort of what Baker is missing. You know, Matt Ryan has been to a Super Bowl and won an MVP. Those are the things Baker's missing, and he might check off some of those boxes this year. If the Browns go deep into the playoffs, if he puts up big numbers and leads this offense, I think this is more an indication of kind of what Baker might be on the verge of becoming as opposed to what he actually is right now.
The other thing is I'm very curious to see his second year in the system. Kevin Stefanski kind of now has a feel for him, the way they worked together. Really, the second half of last year and into the playoffs was pretty impressive. And I think it's going to continue to grow and expand and get even better. Do you think it's fair to expect that?
I think it should absolutely be expected because we saw what happened during the bye week last year. They had that bye week right in the middle of the year. I mean, I think those players were ready. I think that's a big piece of why they lost that home game to the Raiders. But the Browns took advantage of that, and they really did remake some things offensively. And we didn't get to see it right away because the weather was really bad in a few of those games. But when they got to Jacksonville, Tennessee, they got into December, weirdly enough, playing in better weather in December than they did, you know, after the bye week at the halfway point. We got to see what this offense was supposed to look like, and they threw in some more play action stuff for Baker. They rolled him out a little more. This coaching staff did a great job of just rethinking this offense at the bye week, sort of like Tampa Bay did with Tom Brady and the Bucs. They used that late bye week. And I think that's the most encouraging thing. If you're looking for a year two leap, it's this coaching staff took about a week and a half to kind of get things in order. Now they're going to have a whole off season. Everybody's back. They know exactly what they're working with. There's a lot of reason for optimism there.
The other thing is the last time Baker Mayfield was in the same offensive system for 2 years was his second year at Oklahoma, his senior year. We know what he did that year. He won the Heisman. So, you know, there are those kinds of things that he can do when he is familiar and comfortable in a system.
And I think Baker is sort of a trust guy when it comes to his receivers a little bit too. You know, he will throw the ball to anybody if you're open, but I do think there are certain guys that he builds a trust with and builds a rapport with. Jarvis Landry is certainly one of those guys. We've talked about Rashard Higgins so much, you know, on this show, in this city, everybody loves Rashard Higgins. It's because of that connection with Baker. You know, he's going to have a better connection with Austin Hooper. You hope that maybe he and Odell Beckham will kind of finally find that connection. So it's not just another year in the offense or the coordinator or the coach. It's having some of these weapons again, you know, some of them going back to his rookie year where he's really built a great rapport and he's going to be able to continue to work with those guys.
It's important to note PFF is kind of the analytics driven website. Baker had the second highest ranking second half of the season. From that bye week on, he was the second highest ranked quarterback in the NFL.
And they're a site that really watches every throw, and they try to figure out what's supposed to happen on every throw. So it's not just, okay, did that ball get completed? It's not just what we see, the raw data, the raw stats. It's, you know, they're watching the tape. And, you know, you can argue a little bit with PFF's grading system here and there and whether they know what's supposed to happen on a play or not. But when a guy is ranked that highly, at least puts you in the ballpark of like how he was playing relative to his peers. And I'm not surprised because especially starting in that Jacksonville game all the way through that divisional loss to Kansas City, Baker played really great football.
Yeah, and you know, it's one thing to say he's playing really well. There puts some quantitative, you know, decision-making behind it.